So the
no
heroes,
more drow.
We know which ones are left open. Obviously, the Elder Titan, Shadow Demon, the ones that stand
Darkseer,
out.
Darkseer, I think, in particular. I think
just
like,
to change it up.
I think Darkseer is. It's like I don't like the Riki first pick without the Darkseer. I think the Darkseer is just a much stronger opener that leads you to a lot more different strategies. Okay. What else is there? Murana. It's also first pick that we've seen a lot.
It's just so clear that secret value this hero, especially with that Aghanim's E-Blade build. Not going to first phase the Oracle. Now, again, this is something that Secret went with, that not first overall pick, but they did pick it first phase.
I mean, we've seen Seneko's Oracle before. He is probably the best in the world at this hero. But Pi has actually shown that he is probably like right up there. These two guys played incredibly well. I haven't seen these two and Z-Freak are like the top three Oracles.
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
That's a change-up.
There we go.
This is, as you mentioned, the Grand Finals meta's like, oh, okay, they're going to always take Oracle to counter our Batrider. Let's just take both.
Yeah, instead of banning it last game, which they had to.
And it sure helps when you have two players that play the hero. You know, you mentioned Seneko's Oracle being top tier. General's Batrider is, again, probably top five in the world.
I think there's not that many other heroes that actually deal well with Batrider aside from Oracle. Venge is definitely the best one, but I would expect it to be banned out in the second phase if it's not. SD, I think it's decent, but I definitely think it's a third to Oracle and Venge.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, it's like... If you're really fast and you actually disrupt the Batrider, it can be kind of clever sometimes.
That's so hard.
It's super hard. Like, you always like actually get to like disrupting your teammate, but you still get pulled in. But
yeah.
Yeah, and there's the Nyx Assassin, which is kind of a different type of counter.
Yeah. Nyx is good.
That's what Fnatic has been using a lot against Na'Vi. You got banned out multiple times against them as well.
Yeah. Secret banning out the Enchantress, of course. Hard Styles Enchantress, pretty staple. Helps out General a lot and just scales very heavily. Elder Titan banned from Na'Vi. Not wanting to play against the same exact lineup, and maybe they want to go for something that actually has a timing window rather than having to play versus another Titan, which can mess everything up.
So really, with the Shadow Demon pick in last game, what was missing for Secret compared to some of the games early in the tournament, they didn't necessarily have any one hero where those illusions were going to be super scary and super hard to deal with. You look at the lineups that they ran early in the tournament, you had Morphling illusions, you've had Alchemist illusions, you've had Luna illusions to deal with, Terrorblade illusions to deal with. These heroes that get super scary as the game goes on. I wonder if they're going to go to one of those heroes here in game two.
I like Morphling a lot with Secret's lineup. I think it's really good versus Batrider. It's one of the carries of choice, I think, just because they don't have any silences right now. With the ET and the Tide ban, I think it makes Slark also a much more attractive pick for Na'Vi. I think that Yoram plays a pretty nice one. It's like, okay, versus Murana, good at killing the Shadow Demon.
Well, Na'Vi this time will take the Elder Titan out of the pool, so Secret won't be able to pick that up in Phase 2 as it did the previous game. They're going to get rid of Bulba's Tidehunter, which was fairly effective again in the early game, but Team Secret are going to take out the art-style heroes. No more Chen and Enchantress.
Yeah, I'm like thinking back to what other heroes Arkstyle plays, because I feel like he just plays these so much.
He plays plays very good Dazzle Witch Doctor.
Dazzle Witch Doctors.
They will run him on Night Stalker as well.
That's my least favorite that I see.
I agree.
I think that was when they were having a bit of they were struggling a bit too, when he was running that more often than not. That's when like the Enchantress Chen were banned first too every game, I think.
Yeah, I want to say they ran it yesterday against Secret as well.
I think
in
you're
the
right.
First game.
I remember seeing one. Okay.
Well,
that's
very
he plays
different.
Rasta too. Yeah, that's right. That's one of his heroes.
Not nearly as much as some of the others that we've mentioned, but this time Na'Vi may be going for a little bit more push potential here.
Yeah, we've seen Secret consistently do very well in lane phase, and getting rid of the two jungle heroes from Na'Vi may go further towards that end. And maybe you're thinking, you know what, we need to capitalize even more on that. And if you're Na'Vi, maybe you're thinking, you know what, during the draft we can give up something in the lane phase, not just be outplayed or anything like that, and we can get something later on that comes to our advantage. And that's how they've executed the last few games.
Yeah, when you look at so many Na'Vi drafts throughout the tournament that were successful, you're almost always seeing at least one of the supports just threatening the enemy side of the map, and that's so much harder, even to the point where Seneko is trying to snipe the courier as Winter Wyvern. So much harder to do that with an Oracle and a Shadow Shaman.
They're also hiding where the bat's going, and they're hiding like pretty much all their cores, what they're actually going to be playing. So it's a really cool approach by Na'Vi to pick up these three heroes in the first three.
So Axe is a little unusual here. There's not really a melee hero that he can pressure. A lot of times what we saw it was like versus the Terrorblade in particular, with the Abba in the offlane. But
dunk through the Oracle ult. Yeah, that's like pretty much the only thing that I could see.
But there's like, how's he going to spin?
Yeah,
there's no. It's very difficult for him to actually, get good targets. Like,
yeah, like
they're not going to clump. Also, but maybe it's to counter like the Shadow Shaman, because Shadow Shaman you rarely see in the offlane, just because his like dual lane and tri lane potential is like, I think, is very weak in the offlane.
Yeah.
And safe lane is great, but you can just counter it with a jungle, no problem. It's not like any of these two heroes are really going to run into your jungle.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. That the Shadow Shaman, a lot slower, is going to be played on the Radiant side, going to try and take advantage of pulls in the Radiant jungle, and Axe lets you contest that extremely effectively, as we saw in a previous game with the Axe of Bad.
It's a lot of push, man.
It's a lot of push right now.
It's a ton of push.
I think Secret needs to probably pick up another hero that can de-push a bit.
Well, that's another thing that Axe does.
I don't know if you like AA, but...
Go for that Keeper of the Light again.
God, all right. Keeper is owned by Juggernaut, though.
Gets awkward only because, remember, they typically will run the Axe on Puppy, but Bulba plays it as well.
I like it a lot, though, versus the Oracle and the Juggernaut heal. Otherwise, they just have too much sustain. Who's going to kill the Shadow Demon wards? Who's going to kill the Juggernaut healing ward in these fights? And, like, right now, I just see, like, the team fight. Everyone just scared of Lasso. You're going to have, like, wards drop down, plopping on a tower, and who's going to really jump in on Secret? I don't really foresee them being, like, huge in the team fight.
Going for the Paten again.
Nope.
That
is a repeat of that dual lane.
Not really showing a lot of innovation with this draft.
Well, the Abaddon, yesterday we would have been like, wow.
Yeah, I mean, right.
Innovation in comparative to like Secret, come on.
That's a really good Razor ban, trying to avoid a repeat there of game one.
Their anti-push is awful right now.
Yeah, it's not good. It's really not good. And all their heroes take time to get items.
They could just like, maybe not a Lycan, because Lycan gets owned by Axe, but just like any decent pushing hero, and I think that...
Maybe we'll see the old Juggernaut Lone Druid combination.
Lone Druid would be great.
Oh my! If they pick Lone Druid, I'm gonna like.
Yeah,
I'm just
actually,
gonna take my headset off and walk out. And, I'll just give you. I'll give you everything.
I was like, man, what other pushing heroes are there? All I could think of was Puggin and Lycan. It's like, I don't think they're gonna pick that. But yeah, Lone Druid sounds amazing.
Yeah, it actually looks really pretty devastating if they did pick that up.
Although I don't know that I've seen Dendi play that mid too often. Maybe here, maybe a couple times.
But Juggernaut,
maybe Jug mid.
Oh, Jug mid, sure. Okay, that makes sense.
They're definitely leaving their options open.
What the heck is Secret gonna do though? EE's hero, or perhaps Arteezy's?
No. We've seen EE and Artur both on the Clinks. On the Mirana.
After Arteezy's Mirana that last game, you gotta give it back.
Yeah,
to him, right?
Yeah,
he played so good,
so well.
I gotta think of something else for Envy here. What can?
How about that Luna you guys were talking about?
Illusion hero, but he takes a little bit too long to ramp up versus Navi's giant push lineup, in my opinion, at least.
Yeah. I think they, like, instant lose, so they pick Luna.
Well, yeah, we were talking about Secret's draft versatility.
Now
here they are.
Now I want them to pick Luna, Ben. Just because
By all
that.
Means. By all means. What else is there?
Okay, Morphling, so like you mentioned earlier. Yeah.
And again, this is the combination that we saw earlier in the tournament. But I think Navi won. Oh my gosh!
High five, baby!
That's crazy.
I'm gonna have to go with Navi.
Also go with Navi.
Huskar with an Oracle. I actually don't really mind the Morphling pick too much. I think it is like the best thing they could have done. But
it's unanimous. This is the Huskar type of lineup that they've been steamrolling people
I think
with.
They got Huskars. So
what a sneaky draft.
Fog, but if there's a win condition here for Team Secret, what is it? What do they need to do? This Husker pick just seems to pose such a problem.
They need to pressure this Husker in the laning phase so hard. He can't get an armlet too early. You can't just let him do Husker things early. They need to just kind of run it, Navi. Honestly, like it's gonna be super hard playing versus. There's so many heals. There's so much potential. Just help up the Husker, which usually it's not even this much healing for a Husker, but they have a lot of other things to amp him up. So I don't know. Secret really has a game cut out for them here.
All right, Team Secret with their backs against the wall, down 2-1, up against Navi's fifth pick Husker. We'll throw it over to LD and Winter for the cast.
Thank you very much, Alan. That's right.
Husker.
Is it going to end like this? Will Secret be getting Huskar'd?
This is like the improvement I see very significant from Navi, where they start to swap around the lanes between Dendi and Dejara a lot. They manage to trick their enemies into thinking that they have the Juggernaut safe lane, so Huskar very more unlikely. So Secret forget about the hero, didn't choose to ban the hero out. and it's pretty decent against what Secret have. They have a lot of magic bursts in their lineup. And Huskar plus Oracle, a very, very potent combination.
I mean, you can gear, you can try to gear like a Morphling up for physical damage. Even Mirana can transition into it, but it's not their forte.
Morphling is, I mean, you can do that, but in most cases, you want to use your spell damage. You want to get an early E-Blade against the opposing team. So this game, you might have to consider maybe going for other options, going for like the Manta, going for more physical damage output.
Okay. Before we get too much into the later game matchup, let's talk a little bit, Winter, about the laning setup. What is the ideal laning setup for Na'Vi, and how does Secret look to shut that down?
I think Huskar's going mid.
Yeah.
Huskar mid would be against Mirana.
He's bottom now, so he was mid before, but I guess they're putting him bottom instead.
I guess it's okay against the Baden Axe. If they have three heroes at bottom. But at the moment, I see Shadow Shaman at top lane.
Oracle is heading bottom now.
Yeah, it's going to be two heroes versus the Abaddon and the Axe. This could be troublesome if he makes a mistake in the lane.
Oh man, Dendi running the Juggernaut here. You mentioned that poor man shield matchup versus ranged heroes mid, and already getting the crit and a lot of damage out.
It certainly doesn't make you a poor man, you know? You have that shield.
Oh my god. Envy is having a rough lane already. He is tanking a ton of damage here. Look, he's almost dead.
Look at his HP. He has two.
He's fully
base rank.
He went fully agimorphed. I don't think he was expecting to have to deal with a dual lane here, Winter.
Yeah, definitely. You look at their heroes, you're expecting a defensive lane for the Shadow Shaman to get levels, Oracle to be protecting their bottom lane against the pressure lane of Axe plus Abaddon.
And then you look at the mid lane here, and really Dendi should not die. I mean, you always have Blade Fury against that combo, unless Arteezy hits like a crazy around the corner type of arrow. So Dendi should farm well. He's even harassing Arteezy heavily. So far, the Huskar probably not going to have the best time, but now they're going to... He still has a bit of support. And it seems like these lanes are going to be quite decent for Na'Vi.
Oh, okay. He's fine.
Yeah, Dendi just getting some damage in on Arteezy there, but... I mean, last game we saw lanes that didn't go all that well, and Na'Vi were still able to turn it around.
Well, this game, Secret does, however, have a much stronger lineup for late game. They have SD plus Morphling.
Do you, looking at how the lineups match up, do you favor either team if it does go to that late game?
It really depends on how much farm the Morphling has, because I think if a Morphling has...
Top lane, looks like there is a dive going on here. They're moving deep on the Pylai die. They get the long stretch, Armstrong shackles out. The zap comes through, the first blood to Na'Vi. Envy does find a counter kill.
This is bad.
But still, Na'Vi getting the early pressure out there in the top lane. And they're also out farming that Morphling thus far.
I think if it goes to late game with a 6 slotted Morphling plus the Shadow Demon, I think Secret has a very, very good chance of taking it. Like, you can always do like slow siege, speed push, and you have a Mirana as well. And Huskar late game, if you're not ahead of the enemy carry, obviously you're not going to be able to match up equally against a Morphling.
Yeah, it doesn't... Seems like that Huskar is going to farm though, so... At least for now, Secret not doing much to slow him down. Is there anyone who's likely to move around and upset the balance of these lanes early? Like, we don't have that Enchantress or Io.
I doubt so, but in the game where they picked the Axe previously, they had the Axe actually running around helping the lanes, which was kind of unexpected because you sort of feel like Axe should focus on getting his own blink, helping his own, like, staying in his own lane or in the jungle. But that game, Puppy was helping around his team a lot, so... We might see the same thing happening for Secret if they decide that they need help in other lanes.
All three cores here farming on the Na'Vi side, but the support's doing quite a bit better on the Secret side. So still relatively close minus the first blood, but they move on to Bulba here bottom. Oh, Snake almost got around him. Could have gone in, but still with the Fire Spears, it might be enough to bring Bulba down. He is able to heal through it, it looks like. The Purifying Flames brings him back up. But still forced off the lane quite a bit here. Well, elsewhere, Envy, again, almost dying, just dropping constantly low. And he is having a very rough time.
Both the carries are getting constantly...
Oh! Again! What? Envy, level 2 Aether Shock. Down he goes. He is as good of a series as Arteezy is having. Envy is really struggling.
What? Oh my god, I can't believe it happened.
I mean, he already had a fair warning once, and he did not respect it. Now he pays the price.
Is that considered overly efficient? Having too much agility? Okay, fine, it's a mistake.
That's efficient.
Efficient. I see what you did there.
One extra E. And sometimes it can be inefficient. But in this particular case, it does cost them a lot. You mentioned needing a farm morphing. That's not going to help matters. Huskar having his way in this lane. The mid lane, a pretty even trade. Denny getting slightly more denies. Overall doing very well. Arteezy is not taking over his lane the way we saw last game. You really can't give him the
matchup. I mean, you can't really kill the Juggernaut. So...
Unless he horribly screws up.
Yeah, unless he's either trying to kill you or he makes a very bad mistake.
And they're going to look for Bulba here. Puppy's not home just yet. They nuke him. They're going to try to burst him down. The Purifying Flames continue to come in, and Bulba melts to the spears as they also dive the top lane, perhaps, it looks like. They're threatening to just start poking his head off from the back, zapping Envy again. This has to be getting Envy's head, as well as being visible on the scoreboard.
Ain't looking good for Secret right now. Ain't looking good.
Jug has Omni Slash too, and he might be able to even kill off this Morana if she makes any mistakes.
Na'Vi's heroes arguably come online faster than Secret's lineup. Like, the Morphing is a much slower call to come online. Like, Juggernaut, Huskar, they don't need that much farm. Like, one or two items, like, one small item on the Huskar, like an Armlet, and for Juggernaut, maybe get the early Yasha and into the Manta, you're ready to fight.
See the rotation now. Pilot and Arteezy are gonna smoke. Where do they go? It's straight onto Sonego. Puppy finds him with the call. The arrow comes through. Good connection there. They'll get the kill. They'll immediately grab a nice rune for Arteezy, and he continues journeying down to the bottom lane. They really want to make a move on this Huskar.
Moonlight Shadow.
And with the Moonlight Shadow, the ward actually did scout it. So Deira should know. And will be backing away a little bit. He doesn't want to fully back out, but he's close enough that Secret could creep in on him. It is nighttime though, and now the TP comes. Oracle, maybe gonna die again. They get the lane ward down, poor Sonego. I mean, I think it's Deira they really want, but they're gonna settle for a disruption. Deira unable to block that arrow in time. He will get to work a bit with the Fire Spears, but he's not really that strong, the Huskar, at this stage, and Secret are gonna give chase. But meanwhile, top lane, you could see Eternal Envy's woes continue. At very least, I suppose, not dying. Na'Vi finding space elsewhere. Dendi looking to push out this mid lane.
And this Morphing is going to spend a long time farming to catch up. He is not going to be a factor anytime soon. Even as a Quelling Blade to help him farm right now.
He actually went for that very early, so... Really does put the EE in efficiency. Dendi poking his head out in the mid lane, continues to cut the wave, wants to punish Secret for their group up bottom. Only done about a third HP, maybe a quarter HP in damage to the tower.
Oh, they have to rely on Arteezy again to do a lot of work. Like, every other hero needs a certain amount of farm, and we see Puppy getting jumped here.
There's
in the
dunk, but Deira, he's gonna explode!
Oh, he got the kill first! He got the kill!
Puppy did get the kill first, gets that bountiful experience.
Oh my... That
normally you don't see Huskar making such bold moves until he's a little bit more farmed and has the armlet, yeah.
Yeah, I guess Na'Vi feeling they have a good early game going, starting to feel a bit cocky, you know.
And warding under creep waves now, too.
I don't care if there's a creep there.
He's like, I'm getting this ward down, man. To be fair, Arxile's done that 4 times, and just to zap Envy every other time. Speaking of which, I mean, I don't know, at this point if you're Envy, you're just like, come on man, seriously, like, give me a break already, top lane.
He's getting
to he's going to the jungle. Time for the jungle morph lane. See the raindrops here for the axe. Mott maybe wanting Envy to get some.
I mean, I expected them to give Envy some help earlier, but...
They took the opposite route of just, like, pressuring the opposite side of the map.
Yeah, but then General was bullying Envy alone in the lane. That's not good either.
So they do leave Bulba parked down here bottom with the Huskar holding the lane, so I imagine he's gonna settle down now, make sure he gets that armlet. Dendi, waiting for the Omni Slash cooldown mid. He's leveling up the healing ward, so... I mean, that's something we want to keep in mind is... the mid-game strength of Na'Vi. When you have the max healing ward, the Oracle with the False Promise, the Rasta ward is getting dropped, and a Huskar up in front with like a Solar Crest, the Dragonlance just sieging the crap out of towers.
That's gonna happen in the next 5 minutes where... Oh, Bulba.
X onto Bulba. It isn't a very long duration one. Then they zap him. They need to get those shackles up, but Bulba phases away to freedom, it looks like.
He should be fine. That's borrow time.
He runs back in. Na'Vi. I mean, most teams see an Abaddon, they're like, yeah, not worth ganking him. They think otherwise, but with the Battle Hunger, they might slow him down a bit here. Snake able to get away.
I mean, Na'Vi's gonna hit their stride very soon with the Armlet plus the Shaman Wards, Healing Ward. I mean, they don't really need much items on the other heroes. They just need their levels and blink on that. Maybe he's gonna go for the Drums build again this game, I'm not so sure about that.
So Bat going...
He seems like he's saving up for the dagger.
Yeah, early Arcane Boots. I guess it does help sustain the push a lot. If they want to go for that. And Suneko will cheekily deny a rune here. Arteezy none too pleased with that one. Bulba just casually...
And he ticked low.
Into the borrowed time.
He ticked low from the Burning Spear, so...
Not the ideal way to use it, but now the Armlet, so... How much, like how soon do they group and where do they focus?
As soon as they have the level 6 on Artstar, I think then that's about time for them to go for objectives.
You know, Suneko. Close call there, Arteezy was having a go for him.
Man, Secret has to be able to do, I mean, get kills somewhere with the Mirana or the SD setting up with the disruption for the arrow, because X doesn't have his dagger right now. So if Na'Vi groups up, pushes down one lane, I highly doubt there's anything Secret can do about it. Okay, so it's gonna be at the drums again. He's not gonna go for the blink, he's just gonna go for...
I kind of like it better this game than the other one.
Yeah, this game I prefer.
Because it's a good 5-man item.
Because they are looking to 5-man early and they are ahead. You can afford to go for a much more greedy build. I didn't like it that game because they were really behind at the start of the game.
And it felt like they needed kills, although to be fair it ended up...
I mean, they got away with it, so... They made it work.
And now, time for the siege. They are leaving the Batrider off bottom, he's gonna deal with that wave. Shadow Shaman still trying to get his level 6, it looks like. Just they'll nuke Puppy a bit, they will lead with Dayara, the healing ward protecting him. As long as that stands, Secret can have a very tough time dealing with this, but meanwhile in the jungle to the north, they've found one. It's Pileidai. Oh. Shadow Demon gets roasted.
This is not looking good, Garmin.
And they still have healing wards. So they are, Shaman wards. We haven't seen those come into play just yet.
One more tower, the next tower. They're gonna press forward.
They can probably go for two if they want to save the wards. Still a tier one bottom, though.
Yeah, this is like the kind of situation where the arcane boots on the Batrider would come in handy for the whole team.
Yeah, someone like Juggernaut, pretty low on the monopole, can really benefit the supports, obviously.
Especially in a game where your supports don't have gold to actually get multiple sets of arcane boots.
Na'Vi, though, this is a slightly bolder maneuver than what we discussed. It's straight into the Roche Pit with a tier 1 still up bottom. Oh, Pileidai, fortunately, did have a ward there, so General not able to lasso him. Dayara playing with fire, though. He's very low. The Abaddon starts to roam towards the pit, but already the Roche about to drop, and it will go to Na'Vi. The Aegis to the Huskar. You know, so often, Winter, whenever a Huskar is in a game, I know you, Fog, Merlini, you all bring up how crucial the Aegis is for this hero. And they get it early, very early.
I mean, it's just like Drow, Ursa. If you get that early Roshan, it speeds up your timing so much.
Oh, looks like they are diving a bit here. Dendi with a bold maneuver.
I mean, they are feeling confident. They are in a very good position right now. As of whole for the game, so Na'Vi are definitely feeling super confident about that. So they are willing to be much more aggressive than normal. I mean, they are already very aggressive by nature as a team.
Mm-hmm. So Secret are going to see this big push coming. Na'Vi have had their early momentum.
There's nothing.
What do you do?
There's nothing they can do. They have to find trade-off, find pick-off somewhere. I do not see any way they can win a head-on fight.
Man, the Huskar really ruins Abaddon's borrow time with those fire spears. You have like no control over when it goes off. That's gonna be a little extra source of frustration for Bulba.
Puppy is so far away from his blink. I mean, nothing is going on for Secret right now apart from getting farm here and there. And I mean, RTZ is like probably the strongest hero right now, so, and he can't really do much to stop the fireman either. Like, the only way he can slow it down is if he finds a singular pickoff somewhere, like now.
Here's the pickoff attempt, the arrow. It's a miss. RTZ, his arrows felt like something out of Robin Hood last
game.
That
was like a kill that they desperately needed to happen for them.
Not happening this time. And instead, Bat will get a blink, he'll buy a smoke, and well, they haven't even needed those pickoffs. We'll see if they do. But Na'Vi dropping the wards now. Second deployment. This time, we'll be looking for the tower.
He's going to try to deny the tower. That's about it.
I mean, like you said, they have to find other options besides the head-on fight. JRL just calmly armlet toggling, laying into this structure, getting healed up by the purifying flames, and the tower will go down. The shaman gets the last hit.
We're going to see a high ground push very soon. Pre-20 minute.
What is like the dream secret scenario for high ground defense? I mean, I'm kind of chuckling just because like they are not a great high ground lineup.
Man, call.
Drag them towards the tier 4s.
Drag them towards the tier 4s. In your dreams.
Oh, this is not the dream. RTZ does leap out. Hey, with the Omni Slash maybe being wasted, perhaps they can... Oh, never mind. Okay. The drums come into play here, as well as the Yasha. It will bring him down. So they lose RTZ.
There goes your strongest hero on the map.
Morana dead. Dayan raw.
And I just don't see
laying into mid.
What can Secret do right now? They are totally helpless against the onslaught of Na'Vi. Na'Vi's timing is just way too strong at this moment in the game.
I mean, Na'Vi has to make a mistake, is pretty much what it seems like at this point. A big one.
Multiple mistakes even. Like puppy.
It's only
there goes
Secret
your blink dagger, my
making
friend.
Them for now, it seems, as he gets caught out and roasted again. Immolates in the flames. Can they finish him off? Dendi's on the chase. He wants a piece of that puppy, but puppy
okay.
did the math, and he'll be fine.
That is good that he didn't go down
but
there.
But this also leaves Dayara. He's just like, yeah, I'm just going to hit towers, guys. Don't mind me. I'm just a Huskar. No big deal. Art style, though, blinking in there. What the hex he was looking for? Or did he get shielded off immediately? Yeah.
It was on his hex was on cooldown. He was kind of hoping to blink Shackle there.
Oh, okay. I thought he hexed something.
Yeah, I don't know.
Anyway, puppy walks away. But Na'Vi walks
okay,
forward.
Okay, the push.
General moving in. Yeah, the 15 minute high ground siege. I mean, we thought it was all about the Drow Ranger. Na'Vi saying, we'll do it old school style with the Shadow Shaman. They drop the wards. And, well, there's a buyback. With that Na'Vi, just gonna wait for the healing ward to kick in. They're not even backing again. The shackle there again will get dealt with. But puppy, it looks like it might be a dieback. Oh, he's okay for now. Bulba though, ultimate gets cracked open. Now he's gonna have a harder time getting into the fray. The arrow comes through, but it's tanked by Dendi, who's very healthy. Dityara still sieging. Na'Vi just swarming into the secret base, battering down the front door. There is no sort of valiant defense in sight. Secret are forfeiting racks while Envy farms, but it is slow farm. He's only working on Alakins last we checked, and that is not an item that's going to salvage this game. General, though, looking for the killing blow. Gets the last off on Bulba. There's the disruption. Now it's Pilot Eye who might become the target. Puppy with the dieback looking for more. They will find a second kill, possibly a third. Arteezy low. The Flaming Spear is ticking him down. Even Envy's got to run. He will survive in the fountain as the Aegis is reclaimed, but Na'Vi straight onto the next lane of racks. They are going to have another healing ward vent short order. They have Huskar'd the opposition again.
Oh, jeez. This is such an amazing performance here by Na'Vi. Great drafting as well. Secret is just...
This is the team that has won the most Star Ladders by far out of anyone. And it's been a while since their last Star Ladder victory. Fell short at the last Invitational, but here they are, Na'Vi, about to take it, mowing down Pilot Eye, hexing up Arteezy, braiding him down as well. Na'Vi, they are doing it in style. Their former captain will fall as well. A triple kill for Dityara, and there's the call. Na'Vi is truly back. They have won their first major tournament in a very long time, and they are feeling it. All smiles, all hugs. This was truly a team effort.
Oh, what a performance, Mr. Goblin by Na'Vi here at Star Ladder. It's amazing. I mean, the team has just gone